The global revenue from AI for enterprises is projected to grow from $1.6 billion in 2018 to $31 billion in 2025. Also, the definition of AI is misguiding to stakeholders, and having multiple technical jargons like machine learning, data science, predictive analytics tend to bring a chaotic understanding of what they are and what they do. I'm Srinidhi, and today I'll be breaking down practical AI along with a checklist to consider before adoption of AI into your business. Simply put, artificial intelligence has two categories, strong and narrow AI. Strong AI is when AI is used in situations where human thought process, decision-making, and responsiveness is completely replaced by algorithms. But this is not what we will be talking about right now. Enterprises need to be practical while considering AI adoption. AI can be the silver bullet which can take your organization to greater heights if used in the right fashion. This is where narrow AI comes into play. Narrow AI defines specific tasks that complements human and not replace them, thereby enabling faster and more accurate decision making. But how do you choose the right use case? In my experience, these are the business factors to look at while building a use case for UI. First thing is to start with the problem or hypothesis, not with the technical solution. Make sure you choose the right metrics specific to your industry that needs to be improved with AI. Ensure the data steward has been part of the discussion from the initial exploratory stages. This is an important point to consider. Business problem and business metrics to be improved should be articulated well to the data analytics team. And there has to be a clear picture of the existing business data landscape for the data stewards, whom we call as data analysts, to arrive at a proper estimate of time and technical expertise involved. If the answers to the above is yes, then we have to move on to the technical factors. And the first and foremost thing to consider is to use the right data. Even if you have thousands of records, if it is biased, then it is not an optimal data to be fed. For example, let us consider a predictive maintenance use case. You need to ensure the availability of historical data. There is no way one can come up with an efficient algorithm with random sample data. Next to consider is to choose the right data management structure. The data management architecture that you are going to consider should be primarily based on your data concentration. Say you're working with the data that is less than 1 terabyte or something. You don't have to incur the operational headache of installing a high-performance computation cluster like Hadoop or Spark, which are responsible for distributed processing. By getting answers to the above business factors and following the technical consideration, any enterprise can build practical use cases which can leverage the power of AI. This is Srinidhi, signing off from Omega Talks, and watch out for this channel for subsequent updates on AI and other technologies. Thank you.